What's up, guys? So today I'm going to be talking about Thor issue number 9. And yeah, I have the comics somewhere in my closet, in my bins, but they're all stacked up on each other and I'm not doing any of that mess. This is another late ass review. Again, I apologize, but your boy has been slacking. Your boy's been going through a whole bunch of stuff, but I'm catching up on it and I'm a man of my word. I'm going to be covering Thor and Wolverine, and that's just what it is. Thor issue number 9 is the absolute shit. My boy Nick Klein comes back in this issue and of course takes it up a couple notches, couple 10-20 notches. That's basically what his art does. It's pure magic. It can turn the shittiest writing, my writing probably, that looks like shit, into fucking Shakespeare, basically. Not really, but you know, it gets close because of Nick's art. And Matt Wilson, he kills it, obviously. I believe he's still doing the coloring. Donny Cates as well. The Dream Team. Thor is the best comic at Marvel right now. I don't want to hear otherwise, guys. That's just what it is. Now, this book, if I can describe it in absolutely one word, it would be epic. So let's get into it. So basically in the beginning, we get a kind of introduction of Donald Blake and where Donald Blake goes back in the day when he would hit that staff on the ground and Thor would come out. That's basically what we're looking into, which I think is just such a cool idea. I'm not too sure if that's ever been delved into before in the comics, but I think it's super dope. And so basically we find out that Donald Blake goes to this weird kind of pocket dimension. In that pocket dimension, he really has no sense of time. He's basically on an eternal sunset walk in this super pleasant neighborhood that goes on forever. And just reiterating the reason why Odin created Donald Blake, he didn't want Thor to just become a mighty god. He wanted him to become a good man. He did that by way of creating Donald Blake for his son to, you know, understand what it was like to be a normal human so he wouldn't just become a big jerk. So we catch back up with Thor and he's with Loki and he asks a favor of Loki, which is for Loki to watch Donald Blake while Thor trades places with him. And Thor at first, and as we've kind of picked up from the last issue, Thor's kind of doing this under the guise of he needs a break, he needs a reset, he just needs to not be Thor for a little bit. But him being Loki and Loki being the master, or the former master of lies, the god of mischief, now he's the god of stories. You know, I don't remember that happening. I need to read up on some stuff, but he can smell a lie anywhere in the universe. And Thor isn't trying to get any rest. What he's looking for is answers, because when Donald Blake is out, Thor goes into this kind of elder sleep where he can communicate with old elder gods and, you know, get advice, learn from them, whatever. And that's where he's trying to go to, trying to seek answers from them. And so Thor puts the hammer down and he transfers. He's in that place where he's supposed to commune with elder gods, but just like with Mjolnir, Odin's magic is fading. And so he drops back down to where Donald Blake usually goes. And this is like, well, it is psychotic. It's truly madness. This whole perfect little suburban neighborhood is messed up. Everybody's dead. There's blood everywhere. And it looks like when Odin's magic started fading, that's when Donald Blake woke up from whatever kind of trance he was in that made him oblivious to time or anything. And he, I guess, started going absolutely mad. Other dark magic is at work, I believe. And on the other end of that, Donald Blake comes out. He is not just the regular old Donald Blake. He looks like fucking Dr. Gero from Dragon Ball Z. He looks like Super Saiyan Dr. Gero from Dragon Ball Z, just with, you know, his hair going up and not down to the side. And he comes out and he whoops Loki's ass and he breaks the staff so Thor can't come back. And that's how the issue ends, with that big, beautiful, expertly drawn full page. This book, it just builds up to just so many great things, so many good reveals. Again, this is a late as hell review. I've already read 10, 11, and I might have read 12 even. I'm not too sure where we're at on Thor right now as I'm recording this video, but it's honestly such a good book. The art, now that Nick Klein is back, the art is just amazing. Colors are always good. Donny Cates is writing. In my opinion, he's the best writer at Marvel right now. And so I'm just so excited for this series. It gets better and better and better. And that's pretty much it. I want to talk further about where I think things are going, because I kind of already know. Not too much, of course, because this thing is going to slowly build. It's pretty crazy. Again, the art, the writing, the colors, everything is epic. There's even a dragon. I don't know if it was the Midgard serpent. I forgot, actually. I need to find the book again. The Midgard serpent or some kind of dragon is there and he's slain. So whatever magic is at play, it's shifting things all around, because Donald Blake is insanely powerful. I can't wait to see even further past two more issues where everything goes. knows. Donny Cates is a beast at writing. I know he's gonna write something epic. This book is epic, guys. Again, I cannot recommend this run enough. Donny Cates, Nick Klein, if you see those names on a book, get it immediately. If you're gonna get one Marvel comic, get Thor. It's awesome. This book just really sets the tone for how epic and how crazy things have shifted in Thor's side of the world. So that's pretty much it. If you've been reading this series, please let me know. If you keep up with these videos and you like them, please let me know if you like them or if you dislike them, whatever. It's all good. But that's pretty much it. If you like the video, leave me a thumbs up, comment down below. And if you want, subscribe. I always appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.